These are the only warm-blooded animals that actually breed right throughout the Antarctic winter. The penguins tend to come back around March, April. It depends a little bit on when the sea ice is firm enough to support the colonies. Most of them do indeed inhabit the sea ice reasonably close to land. The pairs have to form. By the time May comes, they have usually established who is going to do it with whom, and the females, after some spectacular courtship displays and behaviors, will produce a single egg. By having a reasonably small egg and a relatively long incubation time, it's over 2 months, the chicks do actually hatch still at the very, very cold time, around about July to August. It's freezing, and if they were to hop off, or be kicked off for that matter, of the feet of their parents, they really would die within minutes. They are entirely dependent on the body heat of their parents. Come September and the sun returns well and truly, and one can actually feel a little bit of warmth even at minus 15 degrees, the chicks suddenly start to appear far more. They are now capable of regulating their own temperature. They require a lot of food, so one of the parents goes off hunting while the other one is still in the colony guarding the chick. As the chick grows, it gets hungrier every day, and eventually it requires so much nutrition that both parents are actually required to go out and hunt. The chicks form huddles, and it is just the cutest thing one can possibly imagine on this planet. Chick huddles are really quite untidy because they haven't quite figured it out yet. They have realized that in order to stay warm, it's a very good idea to huddle together. But sometimes they're upside down and back to front, and it isn't really working all that well. By the time they actually leave the colony, they're about 80% of adult size, usually weighs over 20 kilos. What the adults do is eventually they pretty much abandon the chick. They just have to make this very difficult decision. How long am I going to feed my little child for before I actually have to start looking after myself? Throughout the molt, they are not able to hunt because they exchange every single feather at the same time. Their plumage is no longer waterproof. So that means that they simply can't go and forage. Once the penguins are in the water, they do what they did before the molt. They start fattening up again, because now it's time to start getting ready for the next breeding season. So it is just a full-on breeding cycle.